So, last time we were talking about linear programs, and I showed you that I said I defined a linear program as simply this: minimizing a linear function over a set P, which was a polyhedron. P is a polyhedron, and this sort of problem takes the form, in general, takes the form minimize C transpose X subject to Ax less than equal to b. So, the constraints that define the polyhedron are these. So, the set P is x such that Ax is less than equal to b. Now, this is what is called the half space representation of a polyhedron. Half space representation. What does that mean? So, if I give you a the way I am defining for you a polyhedron is through the half spaces that whose intersection if I take gives me the polyhedron. So, this is for these are for example, this is my I have drawn the polyhedron and these are the half spaces that define, right. So, I am defining for you the half spaces whose intersection if you take the gives you back the polyhedron. Now, the thing that I want to show you today is that actually there is another way of representing a polyhedron, which is another way of representing the polyhedron, which we saw. We saw that actually through what is called the Minkowski Weil theorem. Right. What did the Minkowski Weil theorem say? Minkowski Weil theorem said that P is a polyhedron this is equivalent to the claim that saying that P is a polyhedron with at least one extreme point. That is equivalent to saying that P is the convex hull of its extreme points plus the cone generated by its extreme rays. Extreme points of P and the extreme rays of P. Now, if the polyhedron is bounded, then this term here, which comprises of the cone generated by the extreme rays, this term is just a 0, and then P is simply the convex hull of its extreme point. So, if a polyhedron, if you have a bounded polyhedron, that means if you have a polytope, and a polytope is simply can be described as the convex hull of its extreme point. So, this set here, the way is actually a polytope, and it is every point in it can be written as the convex combination of these 5 points, these extreme points, right. So, this now this way of representing a polyhedron or a polytope more specifically, this way of representing a polytope as not through the half spaces that define the polytope, but rather through the extreme points, these extreme points. But this way of expressing a polytope is what is called the vertex representation. Now, what I will show you now is that if you had the vertex representation of a polytope, okay, the problem linear programming would be very easy. It would be very easy to know what the optimal value is and come up with at least one solution for your problem. Okay. Now, if you so what that would mean is that the challenge in linear programming is that we do not is in coming up with the vertex representation, right? So you are given usually a problem that is in the half space representation. You know, the polyhedron is defined using the half spaces that form the faces of the polyhedron. Okay, that is the and what we do not know is where the vertices lie. They have to be computationally discovered as part of the solution method. Is this clear? So the all the so solution method is effectively trying to find or enumerate the vertices of the polyhedron, the extreme points of the polyhedron. Okay, that's okay. So let me just show you why this is the case, that if you had the vertex representation, or if you more generally, if you had a representation of if you had a description of all the extreme points and the extreme rays of the polyhedron, then linear programming would be trivial to solve. Okay, so let's just look at this. Okay, so this basically, so in order to talk about this, let's just get an intuitive picture first. So I'll just draw a neater diagram of the same thing here. So I have suppose a polyhedron like this. This is my polyhedron. Now I'm optimizing a linear function over it. Okay, and now let me plot. So this is my polyhedron. It's in some space. Say let's for simplicity here, it's in R2. What I'm going to plot is the contours of the linear function that I'm going to optimize. Right. So I'm going to plot contours that look that are of the form that so this contour here. This is some C transpose X equal to K. So it's the X is such that C transpose X is equal to K for a fixed constant K. Right. So what this means is take any point on this contour, and the value of the objective on that for that point is K. Right. Now you can draw this contour for these kind of contours for various values of K. So you have this is K dash, this is K double dash, etcetera, etcetera. Now what can you observe about a contour like this? So let's keep our focus on this one. Let's look at this contour. What can you observe about it? So it intersects the feasible region. That means the polyhedron over which you're optimizing. It intersects the feasible region here, right? These are all in this. This is the intersect. So these are all the points that are in the polyhedron and give you objective value K. Now question is, are any of these optimal? Can any of these be optimal? The ones, can any of these give you the minimum value of K? See, if you think about it a little bit, you will realize that it's not, these cannot be optimal. Okay, I don't need to tell you what the value of K is for that. Whatever be the value of K, these cannot be optimal. The reason is because this is a linear function, it should be that the function either increases in this direction or in this direction, right. So nearby here, either to the north of the function, either above this contour or below the contour, you should be able to find a value that is either greater than K or less than K, right. So you should be able to get values K plus minus delta for in you know small enough delta in the by perturbing this contour a little bit, and by perturbing the contour a little bit, you are not going to lose feasibility. You are going to still be inside. You are still going to have points in P, right? So what this means is a contour like this cannot comprise of optimal solutions. So suppose, for example, since I am talking of minimizing the function, let's suppose that the function is decreasing in this direction. Okay, so this is the direction of equals, this is the direction of decrease. Of the function C transpose. So, which means that if I look at a contour here or a contour here, etcetera, as I go in this direction, I will keep getting lower and lower values of k. Right? So what this means is, in order to optimize the function, I need to search in this direction. Right? So I need to look for a smaller contour with a lower value of k, and a further lower value of k, and then finally, it should happen that I eventually get to a point like this. What sort of point is this? This is a point where the contour just passes only through my extreme point, right? The contour just passes through only my extreme point. Now, if I look for a value of k that is even lower than this, then the contour will not even intersect the feasible region, right? So then you are, that's a value that's not even feasible. So below this, if I look for a contour that has value less than this, this is not going to intersect the feasible region. Is this clear? So what does this observation tell you? This observation tells you that there must be a solution of this linear program of minimizing C transpose X over this polyhedron. Right. If you look at that linear program where you are minimizing C transpose X over this polyhedron, there must be a solution of this linear program on an extreme point of P. Right. There must be at least one extreme point of P that is a solution of this linear program. Now, it can happen that there can be multiple. For example, you know, it can happen that the contour is shaped in such a way that, you know, when it actually passes, say for example, let me draw it here, the contour has a the slope is such that when it passes through this extreme point, it actually coincides perfectly with this face, with this edge here, right? And then therefore, it will end up passing through this extreme point as well. So, in that case, both of them will be optimal solutions. In fact, all of these will be optimal solutions. That can also happen. But there will at least be one which is an extreme point and an optimal solution, right? The main lesson here is that the thing that we expect from a linear program is that, let's say consider the case where you are only optimizing over polytopes, that means you are over bounded polyhedra. The nature of solutions that we expect is that there is going to be an extreme point that's a solution, right? So, now come back to this way of representing this thing that I mentioned, which is representing a polyhedron using its vertices or using its extreme points alone. So, if someone gave you not these constraints like this, not the constraints Ax less than equal to b, but rather a vertex representation, that means a list of points that are the extreme points of your polyhedron, then optimizing a linear function over that would be trivial. You would have to just check, go through the list, enumerate the values of C transpose X for each of those extreme points, output the list. Okay, that would have optimized the function. Right? So, the challenge in linear programming comes down to precisely this issue, that we do not know where the extreme points are, and we do not know means that we know them implicitly. We know that they are extreme points of this sort of set, but the exact formula for them or the exact values of them have to be discovered by doing some calculations and some on top of this, these constraints, right, given these numbers, right. So, they have to be discovered as part of the from the problem data. Is this clear? Any questions about this? So, now let me answer, let me address the more general case. Suppose you have not a polytope, but a general polyhedron which could also be unbounded, and okay. So, let me address that, and so let us try to, let us just write out a theorem here. So, let P be a polyhedron, with at least one extreme point. Consider the linear program, minimize C transpose X, subject to AX less than equal to B, and suppose the optimal value of the LP is finite. We are talking of an LP where you are minimizing the objective. So, the optimal value of this LP is finite, means that effectively it is not minus infinity. So, it is definitely greater than minus infinity. That is what it means, right. So, you cannot keep getting lower and lower, as low a value as you like. That sort of thing is not possible. So, that is the sort of case we are considering. So, let P be a polyhedron with at least one extreme point, and we are considering an LP whose value is finite. Is clear? Okay. Then there exists at least one extreme point. So, here I should write P is there exists at least one extreme point of P that is an optimal solution of the LP.